Welcome to another episode of Outdoor Cast Iron Cooking. I'm Dean, the fog crawler.
Hi, I'm Joni, the teardrop nanny. Throughout all my life, since I was a kid doing family camping, in my teens doing backpacking, and now when we do our trailer camping, I've always been responsible for taking some kind of a sweet treat to eat. Today is an easy shortcut, camper cookie cups.
My backpack always had a stick of salami in it.
Well, yeah, you were kind of a renegade.
Stay tuned.
I'm using a 12-inch Camp Chef muley today, and I have a mini muffin pan. I hope you can find one that fits inside a 12-inch. Mine is just about to the bottom, and it's all right if it's not totally flat. If you don't have a 12-inch, you can try it in a 14-inch. I've used the cookie doughs that are refrigerated quite often, and this time I was delighted to find the Reese's peanut butter cookie dough, because this camper cookie cups goes for a cookie dough which is peanut butter. I also have some trail mix, good old raisins and peanuts, but now I have in it some M&Ms and white chocolate chips. You're also going to use some creamy peanut butter, a hazelnut spread. This one is just called hazelnut spread, but Nutella also works. This is what they will look like before they've cooled down, and I put them inside little baking cups just to make them hold better when I go ahead and fix the topping. This is what they'll look like when they're done. I'm using for the first time this peanut butter cookie dough, and this is 16 ounces, and I really like it because it already comes in these little pillows, which will make 2 dozen cookies total. So I take my first dozen, I put them inside a well-oiled, inside and along the sides. I used a canola spray, then I dabbed a tiny bit of the canola oil down at the bottom. I'm not using baking cups in these. When I have used baking cups in the past, I've had to take them and spray inside the baking cup as well. When I place each of these inside here, I'll have the full set of them. Then I'm going to go back and I'm going to push them down and make the sides come up so I have a little indentation in the middle. When I take them out, I'll push them down while they're still warm using a wooden handled spoon to make the indentation deeper. So just start by pressing the finger down. Then go back and mold them along the sides like this. Once I have all of them done, they'll be ready to bake. Here's what the pan looks like when I have them all in place and indented. I'm letting the Dutch oven heat to 350. Meanwhile, I'll go ahead and mix up the hazelnut spread and peanut butter. This isn't rocket scientist here, this is just plain old cooking. About a half a cup of each if you're doing 2 dozen cookies. If you're only doing a dozen, a quarter cup and a quarter cup. But you can make it to your liking. I'm not putting this in right now, but I'm just mixing it up and I'll set it aside while the oven is heating up. Then I'll insert the tin into the heated oven. This 12-inch Camp Chef has been heating. It's at 350. There's 17 coals on the top and 8 on the bottom. I'll put this tray in, cover it back up. I'll let it go 10 minutes and I'm going to check it. These cookies might take anywhere from 12 to 14, but I want them to be a nice brown color since they're peanut butter. Here's 10 minutes. Let me take a look. Nope, put it back on. Got to go a little longer. Couple more minutes easily, 12 to 14, 350 degrees right now. Oh, that looks very nice. I'll go ahead and remove them and put them on the wire rack. While they're still warm, I want to take and use the wooden spoon to press down that indentation in the middle some more. The wooden spoon handle that I'm using has a head that's smaller than a dime. What I'll do is go ahead and just gently press down while they're still wet to enlarge that inner part. Then I'll go ahead, when they're cooled down in the pan after 10 minutes, I'm going to move them to the wire rack and let them cool another 10 to 15 till they get completely cooled before I put any filling in them. What I found is it's good. You go in there and kind of just go around, roll it around like this to make that indentation so you can put that mixture of hazelnut and peanut butter inside. Now that these cookie cups have cooled in the pan for 10 minutes, I'll just loosen them up, use a little bit of a fork or even a spoon, and put them on the wire rack to cool. Then they'll be cooling about 10 more minutes. I'll let them cool 10 minutes, then I'm going to put them inside these baking cups. One of the reasons why I do it like this is because then it's easier to stuff them, plus the peanut butter can be a little oily on the bottoms.
Hey, there's one missing.
Imagine that. Now that the cookie cups have cooled, I'll go ahead and spoon the hazelnut and peanut butter mixture in so it's at the top. There are so many kinds of trail mix now besides good old raisins and peanuts. Just add what you'd like to it. It's good if it has a candy in it, like a chocolate. I have white chocolate chips, M&Ms, peanuts, raisins. Fill them up. Because they're soft, you can push them down. If somebody has a nut allergy, you can make these with a different type of a cookie. You can do it without nuts. You can also fill them full of marshmallow cream. You can use a favorite cereal, or you can use another type of filling like a jam that you like to put inside of it. Once I get these topped with a little bit of everything, they are ready to eat. Trail mix has come a long way since we first started cooking and eating in the outdoors. This takes it to the next level.
We hope you enjoyed today's episode. I'm Dean the Fog Crawler.
I'm Joni the Teardrop Nanny. Until the next time, happy trails to you.